Welcome to Business Analytics Using Forecasting. I'm Galit Shmueli. In this video, we're going to look at an issue that is often overlooked when we're crunching data. It relates to the discrepancy between the dynamic nature of time series data and the frozen nature of a file. Let's recall the MRT ridership data example that we saw in the last session. And specifically, assume that we have 20 years of daily data for the ridership. We talked about some notations that you'll recall from the last session, talking about T, which is the running index, Y sub T, which is the value that we're measuring. So here we're looking at passengers on a certain day. And then we talked about the forecast and the forecast error. Using this example, let's talk about the difference between forecasting a future value and forecasting a past value. Suppose that we're looking at 8 days of data. In this example, we see the x-axis is t, from 1 to 8, and the y-axis is the number of passengers, is denoted yt. For forecasting a future value, I can only use data from previous time periods. In this example, if I want to forecast the value at time point 9, then I can only use data until time period 8, until t equals 8. In contrast, suppose that I need to forecast or fill in the value for time point 3. What is the actual value? Maybe it's missing because it wasn't collected, or maybe that data was corrupted. So I might use forecasting to fill in that number. In that case, we can consider using data from before and after that time period. I can use data from time periods 1 and 2, but I can also use data from time periods 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So that is one big difference between forecasting a future value and filling in or forecasting a past value. Sometimes we use the term impute when we're talking about forecasting a past value. Notice again that forecasting methods that focus on the future will not use data that is farther into the future. But if we're trying to impute a past value, it is legal and we can use later data. The lesson from here is that the data that are in your file might actually be misleading you. The fact that they're there doesn't mean that you're necessarily going to see them at the time of prediction. So, the data file is frozen. It shows a time series at a snapshot in time. Whereas when we're talking about forecasting, that snapshot might not be reflecting the data that we have at the time of prediction. In the table here, we're going to look at the data as it is collected by the MRT system. In the chart at the bottom, we're going to see how the data arrives to the analyst's computer. For example, on March 28, 1996, the data are collected by the MRT system and immediately show up in the file for the analyst to analyze. The next day, March 29th, the system collects the next data on the number of passengers, and that data arrives again at the analyst's computer on day 2. And we can continue doing this. We can see that every day, as the data is collected by the MRT system, it appears in the analyst's data file or machine. So in this case, if I'm trying to forecast what is going to be the ridership on the 9th day, I can use all the information from days 1 to 8 and generate a one-step-ahead prediction. So on day 8, I can generate a one-step-ahead forecast for day 9. In this case, F9 is going to be F of 8 plus 1. But this is not always the case. In many applications, there is something that will cause some delay between the time the data are available or collected and the time that they reach the analyst. Let's look at another example. Same data, same example, except that now let's suppose that there's a 48-hour delay from the time MRT system collects the information and the time that this data reaches the analyst. So now, on March 28, 1996, at the end of the day, the system collects the data, but the analyst doesn't get it yet. The next day comes, March 29th. New data are collected. Still, the analyst does not see anything on that day. On the third day, on March 30th, data are collected, and only then does the analyst get the data from t equals 1. So notice that on March 30th, MRT system has already data on 3 days, but the analyst only sees the first time point. Similarly, as we move now day by day into the future, we're going to get one daily number, but that is a two-day-old number. And by April 4th, which was before day 8 for us, this is day 8 for the system, but not day 8 for the analyst. By day 8 here, the analyst only has 6 days of data. If I still want to forecast what's going to be the passenger ridership on day 9, I now only have 6 days of data, and I have to skip farther into the future. So now, F9 is a 3-step ahead forecast. It is F of 6 plus 3, which is a completely different task than forecasting 1 step ahead. So considering a delay in the system is going to cause you to create a different model, maybe. It will show you different performance than if there is no delay in the system. Now let's think about another example. Let's assume that in addition to the ridership data, we also collected the daily temperature, for example, the maximum temperature in Taipei. If I want to include this information in forecasting ridership, because I think that temperature might affect the number of passengers on MRT, then I have to think carefully whether this information is actually going to be available at the time of prediction, and if it is, when exactly am I going to have access? Are these the actual temperatures, or were these the forecasted weather temperatures? And in that case, we have to think about the availability of both. Obviously, I don't know the actual weather until the day happened, whereas a weather forecast might be available earlier. But then, how earlier? The bottom line here is that the fact that you have data in your file or in the rows doesn't mean that you will have it at the same time points when you're deploying or creating your predictions or forecasts. So the bottom line is that you constantly have to keep in mind the deployment scenario. And in future sessions, we're going to talk about the idea of mimicking the deployment scenario. The two issues that we discussed here of forecasting a past or future value and considering carefully when data are available in your file are closely related to the issue of deployment. So constantly ask yourself what data will be available at the time of deployment, and don't just rely on what you see frozen in your file.